What up, guys? Mad Scientist 7890 here. Normally, I don't do reviews of Raw, but I think I'm going to start doing some of them. Pretty intrigued with what's going on right now, so I kind of just want to, review them, give my opinions on what I think's going on. Trying a lot of different things here, and some of the things I really like and some of the things I don't, and that's why I think it's a perfect time to, maybe start reviewing some of the Raws. I always make sure I watch Raw. I maybe miss a SmackDown or an Impact here and there, but I always watch Raws. Starting the night off with Raw here, I was expecting to be some fallout here or something, from Hell in a Cell with a promo or something big going on in the beginning, but it wasn't. It was just Orton and McIntyre in a match. Kind of disappointing, but, kind of fresh in the sense that a lot of the Raws of recent just kind of open with a promo or open with a segment to begin with. I was not expecting this. Basically, this just to get over Orton to be... him losing again to Mark Henry twice on pay-per-view to kind of get his steam back. Nobody thought that McIntyre was going to win at all. But looking good at least, McIntyre looking good here for the most part. Afterwards, Orton hitting McIntyre with another RKO just because he can. And after that, Henry comes out, kind of comes at the end and just holds the title up, and Orton goes after him and just... right where we, lasted off from Hell in a Cell with them brawling with each other at the end of their match and had people breaking it up and all that stuff. And, basically leading into Henry getting ready to have a match, and he has a match with John Morrison. John Morrison comes out, and he just looks like why am I still here? just never getting over, always losing, getting squashed, and ends up getting squashed here. Looked pretty good, actually. There's times where you thought he might have kind of snuck out a win, but history tells that never happens against at least against Mark Henry usually. But and Mark Henry getting a win here, and basically getting on the microphone and saying, "Orton, I'm done with you. You had your rematch. I beat you the first time. I beat you this time. You're done." And mentions Big Show's back on SmackDown this week, and Big Show's coming after him, and he's got an open invitation and all this crap. So. Interesting to see where they're gonna go from there. I hope there's not a Mark Henry Big Show feud. Those matches will just be no good to me, honestly. But Mark Henry looking dominating here again, and some pretty good stuff with Mark Henry again, at least. After that, they have a promo backstage with Vicky and all the group of guys that she's wrangled up, and John Laurinaitis is back there saying, we need to take action and all this, blah blah blah. So they decided to go to the ring, cut promos, and I didn't really like this promo thing where they were all in the ring cutting promos, like one right after another. It was bad. It really was bad. I like Cody Rhodes as a young upstart. I think he's on his way up, but he just sounded real dumb, kind of. And Jack Swagger, to me, just should never talk, ever. Jack Swagger was somebody who I liked when he first came in. Just totally fell off the face of the earth to me. One of the just people I just can't stand right now is Jack Swagger. I just can't stand him. He's just promo wise, just look wise, the way he carries himself, the way he smiles. I don't like him. But there was a couple little tidbits in here with this that was okay. Triple H comes out and he's basically like, doesn't resolve anything. Just basically says, shut up. Everybody, I don't care if you do a lawsuit, I don't care if Miz and Truth do a lawsuit or any of that, you're all just being babies. That's basically all he said, and he just left. That was it. Not resolving much of anything, but really not, pretty much being, it almost seems like, to him, he's like, his intelligence is being insulted by some of these storylines, and he kind of just is like, really? And he just does his own thing. And it's interesting to see where they're going to go from there, but I don't know. But he played it off well and played it off like none of it mattered. And it really doesn't until we find out what's going on with this weird feud. Next, we have Kelly Kelly and Eve versus Natalya and Beth Phoenix. Again, these matches they continue to have here. Match, started out like it was, I thought it was going to be. I really actually liked this thing that they did here. Kelly Kelly just lost it. Just lost it. She just lost her mind, screaming and just destroying Beth Phoenix. I thought it was very good. I think it was very well booked. Beth Phoenix throwing her out of the ring and then going after her, and Kelly just losing it. She could just do no wrong with that. I thought that was absolutely great. I can't wait to see what they're gonna do with this. I liked that. I really thought that was a good setup. There was no match. It was DQ'd. Kelly Kelly turned into a beast, and it was awesome. I liked that. Next, they mentioned that, you know, Laurinaitis has this thing where they're gonna do a vote of confidence between all the wrestlers and everybody at the end of the night. You know, see who's on who, what side, and you know if Triple H just should continue to have his job or quit or do this and all this stuff, and lead up to that. So that's how that happened. And then Santino Marella returned, and he had a match against Jinder Mahal. Jinder Mahal cut this promo at the beginning that was just absolutely horrible. Just, it was dumb. And then Santino Marella came out, was making fun of him, and just kind of just making jibber-jabber noises. And the match was real short, pretty much to get Santino back in there, pretty much to crash, just completely crush any hope you have of Jinder Mahal being anything right now. Marella wins. Didn't care for this. Thought this was just pointless. Next, they have the 12-man match that they set up in the beginning of the night. And it's... I don't want to miss somebody like Triple H did, if you caught Raw. He missed somebody when he was talking. But a 12-man tag match. It was Cena, Punk, Air Boom, Sheamus, and Mason Ryan versus Ziggler, Swagger, Rhodes, Otunga, Christian, and Alberto Del Rio. This was pretty good. I thought this was good. I thought this was booked well. They did a lot of hot spot tags. They did a lot of different here and there. They did a whole towards the end, everyone hitting big moves on each other at the same time kind of deal. Sheamus getting the win here off a bro kick. The Faces getting the win on this, and you know, pretty good and pretty much shutting down what we're calling the babies. Triple H is calling right now, and you know, I probably agree with that. It doesn't really seem like this faction, it looks like it should be badass, but it's not. It kind of just seems like a group of just, you know, just whiners together, and I don't know, they really don't have much of a point or anything. They're kind of just together and basically trying to screw Triple H. And it all come to head, something, you know, here, big storyline with something, and obviously something's going to happen, but which leads into, finally, the vote of confidence. They have the whole roster come out, surround the ring, and, you know, Triple H come out, get on the microphone, and it was funny and noted that I was watching, there were some people that weren't out there, you know, I guess some, you know, Orton, Cena, Punk wasn't out there at all. I guess, you know, maybe too big for the segment. I have no idea, or they just didn't want to be a part of it at all. Kelly Kelly and Eve wasn't out there. So, I mean, other than that, pretty much the rest of the roster was out there. And Triple H cuts his little, you know, thing, saying, you know, this, blah, 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 I've done a good job. You know, it was a lot. I didn't think it was going to be this much. You know, it wasn't something I wanted. It was just given to me, and I'm trying to do the best I can. And, you know, have a certain, you know, area around the ring, each person kind of with a microphone representing a certain area of, you know, that is like a heel section and kind of a, you know, a mid-card section and the women's section. You know, Wade Barrett talking about, you know, being, you know, afraid to come to work and all this crap, and Triple H saying, oh, coming from the guy, you know, from Nexus, who, you know, if you're not doing the destroying and you're not doing the this and that, then, you know, you don't deserve, you know, why are you even speaking? If you're not the one that's doing it, then you don't want to be, you know, oh, we're afraid. And then they have, you know, the referees were out there. They had Mike Chioda speak on his half and say, the refs were afraid to come to work. You know, 23 years they've been working, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, I've never been afraid to come to work like this. And then had Beth Phoenix speak for the women's wrestlers, you know, saying, you know, nothing's happened to us yet, but what if something could happen? Something bad could happen to us. And Triple H says, nothing happened to any of you guys. You guys are over-exaggerating and all this. And then finally, Jerry the King Lawler came out. He came out at the one of the last people to come out. And, you know, was talking, got in the ring with Triple H and said, you know, I'm afraid to come to work, you know. It's just not where I want to be. It's not a stable environment. All this stuff happening and chaos and this and that. And, basically saying, you know, I'm sorry, but I have a vote of no confidence. Then the refs say a vote of no confidence. The women's division, you know, Christian spoke and said, you know, let's get this down to brass tacks here. We say no confidence. Everyone said no confidence. And everyone, you know, King left. He's like, I'm going to leave. And then everyone started gradually leaving, you know, like it was a dramatic ending or whatever, you know, they have majority of the heels leave first, some faces leave, the last group to leave was, you know, this group at the end, which was like Bourne and, you know, Air Boom and Riley, and you know, a big baby face group, they finally just leave and they're like, eh, we can't, I'm sorry, we can't be a part of it either, you know, and finally, you know, Booker T, Michael Cole leaves first, Booker T leaves, the ring crew leaves, the video camera people leave, the last person is just sitting there, it's just JR. JR's just sitting there, and he's the only one left, and then he's like, sorry, and he had to get up and leave too, he was the only one, and he just leaves Triple H in the ring by himself, just looking at the crowd, just chanting Triple H and all this stuff, and, you know, saying, hell, I'm sorry, I don't know what, you know, and I like this, I thought this was an interesting kind of thing they did here, you know, it's obviously, you know, something going into the future, someone trying to screw Triple H, and that's what they talked about with this as well, out of his position at where he is, you know, whether it be Laurinaitis, whether it be somebody else, you know, a lot of talk of it maybe being Vince McMahon, you know, you don't know what it is, but I am definitely intrigued. I'm going to continue to do these Raw reviews. This one's pretty late here, kind of just last the moment, decided to do this because, you know, I wanted to start doing them, but I was waiting for a real good one to start on. I think this is a good one, and I'll continue to do them and as the storyline progresses because I want to see where this goes. They're really trying to draw people in and do new things here, and I like some of the stuff, and I don't like some of the stuff. So I think that makes a good dynamic for me to talk about, you know, what's going on and you know, pick and choose, you know, throw the dart at the dartboard and kind of just see where things land with this whole Raw situation. So, yeah, that was my first Raw review. Like I said, leave some comments if you guys, you know, have some ideas on what's going on or anything like that. If I should continue to do these, I'll probably do a couple more and see how they work out. But, yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Thanks.